I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. Quarter piece, got war and peace inside my DNA. I got power, poison, pain, and joy inside my DNA. I got hustle, though, ambition, flow inside my DNA. I was born like this, and sworn like this, immaculate conception. I transform like this, perform like this with new weapon. I don't contemplate, I meditate, then off your head. This that put the kids to bed. This that I got realness. I just kill disgustings in my DNA. I got millions, I got riches building in my DNA. I got dark, I got evil that rot inside my DNA. I got off, I got trouble, some heart inside my DNA. I just win again, then win again like Wimbledon. I serve, yeah, that's him again. The sound, the engine in is like a bird. You see fireworks and Corvette tire skirt the boulevard. I know how you work, I know just who you are. See, use a your hormones probably switch inside your DNA. Problem is, all that inside your DNA. Daddy probably snitch, heritage inside your DNA. Backbone don't exist, burn on side a jellyfish, I gauge. See my pedigree, most definitely don't tolerate the front. Like been through, probably offend you, this is Baller's oldest son. I know conviction, burners, boosters, Baller's dead. Redemption, scholars, fathers, kids and I wish I was fed. Forgiveness, yeah. Soldier's DNA, born inside the beast, my expertise. Check out in second grade when I was 9. On sale motel, we didn't have nowhere to stay. At 29, I'm too antisocial, extrovert. An excellent mean an extrovert. An absentness, you hurt. And passiveness never struck my nerve. And that's a riff from the penis case. The reason my power's here on earth. Salute the truth from the prophet, say. I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA.
This is why I say that hip-hop has done more damage to young African-Americans than
I live about my DNA. This is my heritage, all I'm inheriting. Money and power, the maker, I'm emeritus. Tell me something, you can't tell me nothing. I'd rather do than to listen to you. My DNA not for imitation, your DNA an abomination. This how it is when you in the matrix, dodging bullets, reaping what you're sowing, stacking up the footage, living on the go and sleeping in the villa, sipping from a Grammy, walking in the building, diamond in the ceiling, marble on the floors, beaches out the window, peeking out the window, baby in the pool, Godfather goes, only Lord knows, I've been going hammer, dodging paparazzi, through the cameras, eat it for daughters, Brock wearing sandals, yoga on a Monday, stretching to the fan, watching all the snakes, curving all the fakes, phone never on, I don't camera stand, I don't compromise, I just penetrate, money, these are the breaks, these are the times, level number 9, look up in the sky, tennis on the way, sinners on the way, on the way. I got winners on the way. You ain't without a on your belt. You ain't without a ticket on your plate. You ain't sick enough to pull it on yourself. You ain't rich enough to hit the light escape. Tell me when destruction gonna be my fate. Gonna be a freak, gonna be a fake. Peace to the world, let it rotate. Money, my DNA.
I done came up, bustin' down the whole broke, step back. Watch people swag, ain't even gotta ask. What are those, what is that? Please don't touch my wrath. Please don't touch my wrath.
I'm racked up like rappers, I'm wrapped up on camera. Get out on camera. Squeeze like asthma. It's rare wrath when I wear wrath. Bear wrath when I wear wrath. Might invest into some rap shit. Look, still shit rap.
And I'm dripping on racks. Brick gonna be the tag. Do the digital dash. Yeah, I'm boasting, never brag.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and you're tuned in to Madden 18 on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's Breeze's Saints going up against Newton's Panthers.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the Carolinas and Bank of America Stadium here in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the New Orleans Saints. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. Nice move at the 40. And he's brought down after a good game. 25 yards, the pickup there, and also a first down. Christian McCaffrey, everybody knows the family pedigree, and they're hoping for a lot of big things from him, aren't they?
He gave great evidence of that while he was at Stanford. Tremendous amount of big plays, whether it was running the ball, catching it, returning kicks, you name it. A lot of people were wondering if he would go at number 8 to the Panthers because he's not a big guy, but his ability to make plays in the open field, Panthers could not pass him up.
To throw on second down is Newton. Well, this is caught. It's Greg Olsen. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Newton to Olsen there for a Carolina first down. These two, Newton and Olsen, they have formed quite a partnership. Olsen, 3 straight years over 1,000 yards receiving. The first time in NFL history, Charles, that a tight end's done that 3 consecutive seasons.
And the tight end's supposed to be an accessory to an offense. But in Carolina, Greg Olsen is the primary receiver.
This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be second and 12. Now the Auburn alum, Artis Payne. And he'll go down at the 28. 12 yards is the pickup there. And that'll bring up a 3rd and 1.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when they're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it, and boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup, and guess what? It's now 3rd and very short in order to try and pick up a first down.
First down, this is McCaffrey, and he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. A gain of 3, 2nd down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey, and he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6. Big boys down there in the trenches and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. It'll be a gain of 4, and that's going to make it 4th down. And Dixon over the middle. They're not going to get it. They try to move the chains with a surprise, but it's a turnover on downs. They pass up the 3, fake it. It doesn't work. On the NFL scoreboard, an update from Foxborough. And the early going, it's the Texans out in front. Deshaun Watson, an early touchdown pass in that one. On 1st down, Breeze. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he's brought down after a good game. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
Throwing on first down is Breeze. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker rule that they can fall back on anymore.
Second down now after the incompletion. First carry for Adrian Peterson. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and six. Good job there keeping him to a short gain. Of course, he's coming off a really terrific performance, reigning NFC Defensive Player of the Week.
And I know people get caught up in, well, if you're the reigning Defensive Player of the Week, you must have made a bunch of spectacular plays. Like, you mixed in a few of those, but most of the plays were just like we saw there. Keep them to short gains, make the fundamental tackle.
Now Breeze on third down. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Breeze now on first down. Finding room to the 20. Going right side here, and that's complete. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. So they're operating in the red zone. Back to the ground, Peterson. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be second and 11. Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. Now Breeze. And he's gonna go down. He's sacked back at the 24. Kaywon Short. Breaking through to get him for a loss of seven. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Saints football to begin quarter number two. They're in the midst of a nice drive, but facing a third and long here. Made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And Lutz puts this one through. And the Saints are going to take a 3-0 lead. And we were scoreless up until this point in the second quarter. Now we finally have a little action.
Let's see where this action takes us. First quarter, no points at all. Now we've got our first score of the game. Well, does that signal that we're going to get more as we go along? Or will it revert back to what we saw in the beginning of the game? At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
A reminder coming up in the Sunday night. Match of Super Bowl 18, the Raiders traveling to Washington, and then tomorrow on Monday night we'll see the Cowboys heading to the desert to take on the Cardinals,
former NFC East rivals.
Give him nine there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
And now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Back to the ground on first. It's McCaffrey. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks, allow other people to make tackles. And when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
From midfield, here's Breeze. Wide open receiver complete. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
yeah,
they?
When we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Throwing on 2nd down. Caught by Snead over the middle. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down. So 3rd and 2, and I count 6 defensive backs out there. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in the cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football. And you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
They pass up the 3, fake it. It doesn't work. Now a play fake here on 1st down. And able to use his stiff arm for a little bit of leverage before he's taken down. A pretty good gain. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll make it a 2nd down. From the gun, here's Newton. It's complete right side to Benjamin. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. A Carolina first, Newton to Benjamin. On 1st and 10, Newton. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Somewhat surprising stat. The Panthers, they haven't had a 1,000-yard rusher on the ground since 09. That's the longest active drought in the NFL, but certainly they're hoping Christian McCaffrey can change that.
Not just as a ball carrier, but also as a pass receiver and take pressure off of Cam Newton, give him some easy completions, and maybe he doesn't get hit as much in the pocket that way.
Now Newton on 1st down. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. They were looking to get it to Kelvin Benjamin there. That'll bring up 2nd down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And he fires one incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because that incompletion's on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Now Newton. And that will be incomplete as well.
That's really nice coverage there. I'm not sure he would have gotten to the first down marker anyway. But boy, oh boy, did they blanket him.
Yeah, short throw, but he really didn't have many options. Had to force it in. Well, he didn't have to, but he chose to force it in somewhere. Incomplete.
Yeah, now brings up fourth down.
This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. Shift together here from the D-line.
Let's go! 3-19! 3-19!
The first down throw for Daniel. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Daniel on first down. Gonna throw right side here. Complete. 15 yards through the air on a first down. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So you got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Here we go now.
Off play action. Daniel. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
There are a good number of coaches at any time they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
The Saints on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. Here it's third and two.
3-39.
To the air again, Daniel. And almost intercepted. Would have been a huge pick in the end zone, but as it stands, that brings up fourth.
And that was certainly an aggressive call and an aggressive play. Instead of just going for the first down.
Now the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. They're not going to get it. They try to move the chains with a surprise, but it's a turnover on downs. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. Newton on first down. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. Now a first down throw for Newton. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Darryl Tapp. Able to drop him for a loss of four. On second down, McCaffrey. And this will go as a short gain on what will be the final act of this first half. So we have reached halftime with the visiting Saints out on top as we send you down to Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry. This one fielded at the 5. And some room to maneuver.
Partner, when I was in college, we used to have these things called game maxims that we did before every game. One of them said, press the kicking game, for here's where the breaks are made, is the area of hidden yardage. How about that return, flipping the field, taking it past the 50, and getting things set up to start the series?
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Breeze now on first down. He's going to look deep. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 14. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
Newton going to hand it off to McCaffrey. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. Only a yard on the pickup, so from a good situation on second and two, it's now third and one. Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. But you just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
Here's the veteran punter Lee as he sends this one away. Just a yard return there after a punt of 49. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Well, pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
There he goes, right side. Touchdown, New Orleans. A big play there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Saints add on to their lead. And now it's blocked. But he doesn't get far. They're able to stop him. And after all that, the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
I rarely question anyone's effort on the field. But normal, you give up a touchdown like that, a long-distance play, there's usually not a lot of resistance on the extra point. In this case, though, boy, they bowed their backs and got after it, didn't they?
Yeah, a little revenge. Nicely done.
Yeah, way to go. Get in there, block it, and show them that they're still fighting.
And the Saints' pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Sheldon Rankins able to get in there and drop him behind the line. This is McCaffrey on the give. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to lead to a third and 11. A shotgun snap for Newton. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. That's taken on the 25. Just a 2-yard return there following a punt of 48. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. first and 10. Here's Breeze. And he's brought down after a good gain. 23 yards on the play.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. The tight end Josh Hill was the target, and now it's second down.
Sometimes you just have to take things into your own hands, don't you? I mean, the offense is really struggling in this game. They're the ones keeping things going. They have to continue to play at that level.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And his throw here is incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Again, they'll throw with Breeze. And he is out of bounds, just a yard or two shy of the 30. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Saints were the best team in the NFL on third down last year. 49% conversion rate helps when you have Drew Brees back there.
It certainly does because he is just so analytical in everything he does. Goes through every progression on every snap in practice, so not much surprises him on game day.
Brees now over the middle, and it's incomplete. Because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulder.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You just handled that pass would go from incomplete.
Brees screen to Powell. And he'll be knocked in good for only two. Now it's third down.
A lot of things have to come together and be well executed, but all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
There's Breeze into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 13. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line. This defense figured out something in the locker room. That's two third-quarter picks now.
And you just wonder, did he get too comfortable in the locker room himself? His team has the lead. Take care of the football. He's putting him in jeopardy right now.
And he's across the 40, three extra yards in six. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Now it's Newton. And he's got Rome. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And he had a nice play there from his free safety position to hold him to nothing.
And, Brandon, remember when the free safety was always back away from the line of scrimmage?
That's changed.
They always that changed in a big way. The way we see it now, they're almost mirrors between the free safety and the strong safety. One will be up, one will be back, or sometimes both will be in the same spot. On that play, the free safety was there, no gain.
Call it a gain of 4, and it'll leave them with a third down and 6 to go. Here's Newton. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line. Nick Fairley able to drop him for a loss of 12. And it'll be fourth down. On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. Now this is fielded in the end zone. No, a nifty juke there.
Not much fun for a guy trying to tackle him.
And we're back now in Charlotte as we are set to bring you the home stretch here, the fourth quarter. Ready. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
So this is what happens when you throw interceptions, that confident veneer that you have. It's chipped away a little bit, maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, under-throwing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions may be in the back of his mind. On second down, Peterson. Now this will go for five up to the 33. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
The Saints on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This will be third and five. Shotgun snap for Daniel. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. 14 yards that time for number 14. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Now Daniel on first down. Looking sideline, incomplete.
That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes it's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. Throwing again, Daniel. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
The Saints on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Breeze to throw again. He is going to find Hill here. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. Breeze now on first down. He dumps it down to Ingram. Flashed the stick skills on that run, but then stopped shy of the 35. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll make this a 2nd down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Now, Breeze again. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just... Second down. And on 2nd and 10 now. Again, it's Breeze. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. Kill, kill, kill. From the gun, it's Breeze. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And oh, the gamble fails. It's incomplete. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work.
I remember being taught that cliches have become so for a reason. A lot of times they're true, right? What's that they used to tell us about letting sleeping dogs lie? But this one wasn't sleeping. Maybe it was just slumbering a little bit. But taking that gamble there, you've got the lead. You may have ignited them. Now they stopped you.
That's exactly right. If you take the points here, you don't shift momentum necessarily on that play. You probably just did. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives them a new set of downs. On first down, Newton. Room here to run. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it a second down. Here's Newton now on second down. And Olsen over the middle. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
We've been together a little while now, partner. How often do we actually describe tight ends as nifty? Because that's what I think of when I see Greg Olsen on the field. His ability to run routes, create space.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off near the 29. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line. Thought they had something going there to break that goose egg here in the second half, but to no avail.
Hope was alive until that interception. What a terrific play, taking the ball away after it looked like they were starting a drive.
And now that shutout still standing. You know that's something those defensive guys hold a lot of pride on, too.
No doubt about it. They're excited about where they are in this game.
That's out to Hill, right side complete. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first. Peterson gets the handoff from Breeze. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
To throw is Breeze. And he locates Josh Hill, complete. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. Breeze going to throw here. He'll find his man on the comeback route. Complete. Touchdown, New Orleans.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Shotgun now for Breeze. And he's got it. So the two-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth-quarter lead. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This will be fielded at the 8. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Now whistles here, and it looks like we've got a Panther that's having some difficulty down there getting up. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Newton now to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. Not a whole lot of room to run. Gets it to the 35 after showcasing the great move. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third. From the gun on third down, Newton. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up in that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
And he will have a first down here at about the 40. It's a gain of 5. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. Back to throw, Newton. This one complete to Devin Funchess. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for the connection with Devin Funchess. And it's second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Ball hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to need a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
Well, yeah, once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. Throwing on third down, Newton. Oh, he's able to outmuscle him here as he pulls it in. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game. Now a first down throw for Newton. He dumps it off to Artis Payne. Stops short of the 25, and that second effort got him a couple extra. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. One last throw here for Newton. And it's intercepted at the goal line. A great read, and it's picked off. And he will be out of bounds here with zeros on the clock as this ball game is over. The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt, the number zero, zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is, and what an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. And how about that zero on the scoreboard for them, going along with those zeros in the time column, too.
So for the Saints, they get back in the win column as they move to 2-1 now on the year. And they'll have another road date next week with the Miami Dolphins. Meanwhile, for Carolina, they'll fall to 1-2. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Foxborough to face off against the New England Patriots. So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. Till next time, we say so long from Charlotte.
Like the way it sounds, Frody?
Yeah.
Just let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe. Just let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe. It's too hot, drop the top off the wagon. Lay back, fire like dragon. Man, I'm flying past Saturn. Out of here like I ain't that savage. It's like I'm at the studio with Michael. You can hear me dancing on the beat. Bam, bam, about to put a mansion on the beach. 100 Latins in your lobby. That's what happens when you're around with body.
and I put that my mommy. I will never give my heart to a two-packer. Just make a dance that goes with this song, then I'ma be on. Basic gon' dance to it. Basic everywhere gon' dance to it. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute. White Range Rover, in it. Let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe for a minute. White Range Rover, ballin' it. Yeah, baby, shake that. Shake that. Shake that. You gotta, baby, shake that. Shake that. Shake it. I got two shows, I'm about to pitch another. Throwing alley-oops to my brothers. We all shine, nobody victims. I'm on these sweatsuits, black pippins. I swag different, that's why the money in the bag different. Come up short, you left your fam. I lay on beaches and swerving whips. You ain't serving, you just an urban myth. Every day, get ride around Queens on the jet ski, it's me. Every day, get to the day I die. Every day, get man, I'm set and I'm set, bouncing up and down. Nearly broke. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute. White Range Rover, ballin' it. Let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe for a minute. White Range Rover, ballin' it.
Honorable C Notes.
Yeah, Lil' Fish. I say, Lord, be my savior when it come to getting this paper. Please protect me from my haters. Just say me and I won't save us. Say amen.
Amen, amen, amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
They bad boys and they can't win.
Can't win.
Check. Corner. We in it, we gonna.
Corner.
Steady like my persona. Corner. Living up with honors. We used to drive them hardest. Then we pull up in the farthest. Go up, walk in.
Can't win.
king is born. I told you before, a king is born.
In the jungle, in the heat of the rumble, I ain't got nothing to lose. Hey. I've been fighting these hard times in the ghettos of my mind. That was victory that I choose.
Hey. Yes, my soul is blessed, the king is born. My mind confess I'm a bad, bad man.
Ain't no one like me. Like a bull in a glass house, no bull about to smash out. Can't nothing stand in my way.
Hey.
I don't care what the pace is, from the penthouse to pavement. You better hear what I say.
Hey, yeah. Yes, my soul is blessed, the king is born. My mind confess I'm a bad, bad man.
Ain't no one like me.
Smoking, a king is
stuck in my worldly ways. Propaganda, press, spend the camera. Please don't look at me in my face. Everybody might see my pain. Off the rail, might myself. Bored with life as aboard this plane. Steward this sex if I need help. Maybe with your last name. Hopefully it still ain't been changed. Something about you make me not doubt your aqua status. My brain scream louder. Asking when I'm going myself. Couple products, my cash ain't help. Human issues too strong for tissue. False provider, won't mask my wealth.
The car's outside.
Got things to do, got to make my moves. I can't miss my flight to miss you too, boo. First class seats is overrated. Won't go unless they overpay us. Nowadays I'm overdating my district for the hurt. Stay well acquainted, their morning is calling me. Good vibrations is all I need, all I need, all I need.
Move your body if you came here to party. If not, then pardon me. How I'm supposed to have a good time with death and destructions, all I see.
everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today's matchup features one team who once took ground and pound. The Panthers are top 10 in rushing yards, going up against the Falcons front seven that will need to be up to the test.
Larry, with a beautiful skyline towering just to the right of us, you get a look inside Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte, North Carolina. Just a moment ago, the lights, the cameras, the action, all the pyrotechnics. Everything was ablaze. Everything was allowed here in Bank of America Stadium as Carolina emerged from their tunnel. And we are ready to go as the Panthers get set to match up with Matt Ryan and the defending NFC champions, the Atlanta Falcons. Now a play fake here on first down. Oh, he's going to air it out. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. They'll run. This is Jonathan Stewart. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Every year I go to the combine, I marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards. From the red zone now, Newton. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
Many teams, as soon as they spot man defense, if they haven't called a hitch, they'll get to it as fast as they can. They want to put the ball in the hands of one of their best playmakers and hope that he can break a tackle on the outside and go for big yardage.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
This is McCaffrey, and he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Panthers take it right down and score on the opening drive. And his kick is right through. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken about the 12. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Throw on first down with Ryan. The left side completion to Jones. A good pickup there. 8. Yards on the first down completion. So they complete the pass and now they face a second down. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. and to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete. Trying to get that in the hands of Devontae Freeman that time. And that'll bring up second down. And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here. This first quarter. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Jones. And some big-time hitting going on there. He is knocked to the ground. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. This is Freeman on first and 10. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. 9 yards still remaining here to pick up the first on second down. On second down, Ryan. And his throw is going to be incomplete. He was looking for Mohamed Sanu there. And it'll bring up third down.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. To throw is Ryan. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Captain Mutterlin. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. We thought this defense would be opportunistic, and they were. Here, you're already up. Now you got a 2-touchdown lead. I tell you, going out there on defense, did they have a little bit of extra momentum with a score already on the board?
Oh, without a doubt. That already felt good to them. They took it and used it and obviously put up another one. But here's the thing now. Some defense coordinators might want to pull their guys back a little bit because they don't want them to make mistakes because they're too overamped. Others say, I've got 2-touchdown lead. Go get them, guys. They'll be even more aggressive.
To the air, Ryan after the pick six. And it's hauled in by Austin Hooper. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Ryan. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 at enemy territory. 15 yards there on the catch and run.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
Throwing right, and that's complete. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Second down, 8. Again, Ryan. It's caught over the middle, Hooper. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Well, this is how you shape the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4-for-4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when and told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row. I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number 2. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Throwing again, Ryan. That incompletion breaks a string of 5 straight connections, and it's second down.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you've got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. Second and 10, it's Ryan again. Quick hitter here. It's complete. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
On third down, Ryan going underneath. It's Coleman, and he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Call it a gain of five, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. They'll try and throw for him with Ryan. And that is incomplete, but there is a flag. And on fourth down, this is a big call. Goal line offense, something they've really been emphasizing in practice lately. Now they have a chance here to put all that hard work to use. They go play action here on first down. The quick slant caught. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Eric Saubert, his second touchdown on the season. And the Falcons have cut it to within a score. And that one makes it 14-7. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. Spins away. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Reminder later tonight, a good one down in Miami. It'll be the Raiders and the Dolphins. A lot of playoff history between those two in the 70s.
Yeah, there sure is.
And then tomorrow night, we wrap up week 9, the unofficial halfway point of the season with the Lions and Packers from Lambeau. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. They go back to Stewart on first, and he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. A gain of 3, second down. On second down, they run with Stewart. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. And Olsen over the middle. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. They'll give it up to McCaffrey, and the play goes nowhere, losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
Wow, that play got shut down in a hurry.
As soon as the snap came, you can see defensively they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line to give you a little bit of space, a little bit of time so you can make a move. There was none there for him.
No gain that time, and it leaves him with 3rd and 11 coming up. To throw on 3rd down, Newton. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. Now it's scooped up, and this is a live football.
Those really long field goals, when they are made, they are things of beauty. But there is a danger to getting them started, isn't there?
Yeah, with that low drive, you've got to really keep it low to the ground, don't you, to get that distance.
Yeah, hard to just pop it up in the air because otherwise it's not going to get there. So he's got to drive it low in order to have the distance. And that usually puts it in jeopardy, gives him a chance to block it, and everyone knows it on the other side. That's when you get your best jumpers on the other side of the field and try and get up and get it. I think that's a big-time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. but able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football. That's why he was able to bat it away.
Second and 10 now, Ryan. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and it'll be third down. The Falcons on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. The former Indiana Hoosier here, Tevin Coleman, losing 2 yards that time, and now it's 4th down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. First down. And an alley to run. And he slides to avoid the hit. Give him 8 on the play, and it'll be a 2nd down. To throw on 2nd down is Newton. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. 3rd down, here's McCaffrey. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Now a 2nd timeout called for by the defense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the outside of the playoff picture looking in. So a lot to fight for.
Yeah, and wasn't it interesting in our meeting with the coaching staff that they all made sure to let us know, we know where we are right now, but the playoffs don't start tomorrow. We still got some time, and they plan on putting it together, formulating a streak, got the whole month of December still left to play. They think they can get in.
And they made it very obvious to us that there's no playoff talk in the locker room right now. It's win. This game and look to next week.
Excellent focus.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And they'll get him down here at the 23. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down.
I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his 5th catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end. On 2nd down, here's Ryan. Gets it off to Freeman. A good pickup there, a 22.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Throwing now, Ryan on 1st down. Wide open receiver complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A good pickup there, a 22. On first down, Ryan. And Jones has it over the middle. And, oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. From the red zone now, here's Ryan on first down. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. Here's Ryan. And he's got it. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. And the 42-year-old veteran's kick is up and good. So it's halftime here in Charlotte with the Panthers out on top as we'll send you down the coast to Orlando where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it.
They've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty neutralized. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now Ryan on second down. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Call it a 3-yard gain. And just like that, it's third down.
This up to the 46, good enough for the first.
A Falcon first down, Ryan to his young tight end Hooper. On first and 10, it's Ryan. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. Now whistles here, and it looks like we've got a Panther that's having some difficulty down there getting up. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Ryan will throw again. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Jones. A phrase we said a lot last year, Ryan to Jones for a Falcon first down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Charles Johnson in there to get him for a loss of 5. On second down, Ryan. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. The Falcons on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be third and 15. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down.
Can you do any more work or make it more dramatic for not much gain than what we just saw there? Did you see how his toes got down? Tip-tap, tip-tap, got him down. But what did he get out of it?
He sold the sizzle. He just had no stake.
I mean, was it 1 yard?
Yeah, you, plays like that, you at least expect a first down. They're just 1 yard. That'll go in the books as just a 16-yard punt. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. And some room to work. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Now Stewart on first down. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. He lost 2 there, and it's third down.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that?
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. Here's Ryan. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. And look out, a big hit to the shoulder pads. Took him right off his feet. A very good gain on first down. 9 yards on the dump off. Second down and just 1. From the shotgun, Ryan. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
Now Ryan on first down. His throw incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Thomas Davis coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8. So the sack pushes him back, and now third and long for Ryan and the Falcons. Ryan. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th. Here's Matt Bosher now as he's on to punt for Atlanta. Fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball,
But sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it. He loses it. Somehow, ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Yes, indeed. That play there, that reminds me of some of the guys that I played with that have that suddenness, able to get into the backfield almost about the time the ball snapped and make a play. How about that tackle for a loss?
Absolutely. He did a lot of that last week when he was named the NFC Defensive Player of the Week. One of the guys on the team was saying, yeah, we called him the disruptor. And that's carrying forward again.
Makes sense, doesn't it?
And again, the run defense stout this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more. Third and long, it's Newton. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Dontari Poe in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. There on the first down completion. Looking to throw on second down. Ryan, quick throw, that's complete on the inside slant. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. And I'm going to keep firing.
Drops it off for Coleman, and he's brought down. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
On first down, Ryan. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. So the offense now dealing with a 2nd and 7. Throwing again, Ryan. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Third down, Ryan. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he showed some fancy footwork on the juke, but then quickly taken down. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to 4th down. Here we go, it's Ryan on 4th down. And it's incomplete, they cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it, and the Panthers will get the football back. They go play action here on 1st down. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll be 2nd down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with 3rd down coming up.
A shotgun snap for Newton. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. Newton on first down. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that can be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got caught for the penalty.
A swift move and then tackled just on the other side of midfield. That's a gain of 6 on the first down run.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
Maybe the old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
Throwing on third and long. Newton and Olsen over the middle. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. Here's Andy Lee now, as he's on to punt for Carolina. And it's picked up by the Panthers.
All right, zero rooting interest in it, but that one hurt.
Well, yeah, you're losing in the fourth quarter. A bad time for a fumble on a punt return.
They had an opportunity. All right, they were sensing. They're down on the scoreboard, and now they just gave that one up.
Draw play, Newton to Stewart. And he'll at least get him inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. This is Stewart again. And a big play there on second down, but we do have a flag on the field. This is in the area where it might be coming back. So he was holding from that left tackle position.
Everyone tries to keep their hands inside when they're blocking ever since they liberalized the rules where you can extend them out. But sometimes they get out a little wide and they get detected grabbing some cloth.
Following the penalty, here's Stewart. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. McCaffrey. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. And Gano's kick is right through. And that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. So, Charles, I think from a defensive perspective, you have to look at that field goal there and consider it a win.
You were able to keep him within a touchdown, so no question about it. That was the kind of stand that keeps you in ball games.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Ryan hit, and he lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
A good pickup there, 26 yards. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot and they connected there and picked up a first down.
He's back to throw. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down. Time a factor as Ryan will hustle him to the line. Back to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A very solid gain of 27. First down now, but the clock continues to move. They'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining. This defense has watched their lead dwindle away. This is where they really need to bow up. They executed well there.
And it's often hard after you've played really well early and then you kind of relax a little bit to step on the gas again. They just did it on the last play. Looks like they want to finish this one off.
On the NFL scoreboard there in the fourth quarter in Philadelphia. And that's now a 2-touchdown game as the Eagles have scored again. Back to throw. LeGarrette Blount, 2 touchdowns on the ground to help lead the way. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. Well, Charles, they were close in the end, but they couldn't get that last play, that last little miracle play done. They were within striking distance, but couldn't find a way to score.
They definitely had hope. They definitely had opportunity, just unable to cash in at the end. Not an easy play by any stretch, but they definitely had a chance.
So for Carolina, they pick up win number 4 on the campaign as they emerge victorious here. And they'll have another home date next week as the Miami Dolphins come to town. Meanwhile, for Atlanta, they drop back to .500 now at 4 up and 4 down. And they will get a home date next week as they will take on the Dallas Cowboys. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Panthers are winners here as we say so long from Charlotte.
Me putting my city all over the map. They wasn't believers, I had to get even in math. We coming up, pulling up, jumping all over your grass. So tell them I got a new girl. Tell them that I'm in the bank and I want all my 50s in cash. I'm tired of living check to check. I need 20 models. This is smiling in my grave, fresh to death. I've been Wu-Tang with a spectrum deck. Getting. Yeah, I got that. I gotta just get off my chest. I cannot miss it. I got less on my list and you next. Take it how you want it. I ain't famous like I want it, but I think I might just skirt off. Blow the speakers and turn off. Pop up. Go to church with my shirt off. Tell the Lord that I'm here now. I've been waiting for so long. I've been patient for so long. Breaking rules like there's no laws, and I did it for a long time. If you don't like me, take a ticket. There's a long line. Nice to meet me. Meet me. I think the pleasure's all mine. They've been clocking me so long. I think they lost time. Ooh, you lost, lost, lost. What you mean? Woo. What you mean? Woo. And now I'm just a so what the what you mean? Woo. Hold up, whoa, 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 what the what you mean?